Namaste and welcome back. In this video, I will be presenting the cryptographic hash function SHA-256, which is very popular in maintaining the integrity of the data and which is widely used in many of the cryptographic applications as well as cryptocurrency and blockchain. Previous in videos, I have explained regarding the cryptography concepts such as encryption, decryption, and the elliptical cryptography, how the public and private key or public and secret key pairs will be generated, and how the encryption can be done using the elliptical cryptography mechanism. These things we have seen in the last videos. And in this video, we are mainly focusing on the concepts such as how to maintain the integrity of the data. And this particular concept is an important concept for understanding the digital signatures that are very, very important for transaction verification and validation in cryptocurrencies. So let us start with this SHA-256. So hashing in cryptography is majorly used to maintain the integrity of data. So integrity of data, in the sense, whatever the data sent by the sender, that data should not be modified by any of the intruder in the middle of the or in the transit of the message from the sender to the receiver. Then how you will identify if that particular data is modified or not during the transit, or any original document was modified or not in middle. Okay. All these things, how we will check it? These things can be checked with the help of cryptographic hash functions. So these cryptographic hash functions will mainly used to maintain the integrity of the data. So the output of the hash function is also called as hash code or hash value or digest. A hash function takes any length string as input and outputs a fixed length message digest. So the cryptographic hash functions, what are there? They will take any size of input data, but will always produce a fixed size message digest or hash value. Hash functions do not require keys to generate hash value. Like encryption and decryption, cryptographic hash functions does not require any secret key or public key in order to generate the hash values. So they will simply take any length input. Some computation will be performed inside. Usually this computation will be in terms of shifting operations, left shift, right shift, okay, like that various operations will be there. After doing all these operations, you will get a fixed length message digest. But with that fixed length message digest, it is highly impossible to get the original message. But even though a small change happened in the original text, then the hash value will become different. So blocks in the blockchain consisting of various hash digests, hash for the current block, hash for the previous block, hash of all transactions in the block, Merkle root hash, etc. in the block headers. So many of the blockchains will maintain these many cryptographic hash values, so that any change in the previous block or subsequent blocks, or previous block or any prior blocks, we can say any prior blocks, then the subsequent blocks will be get disturbed, because the subsequent blocks consisting of the hash value of the previous blocks. If the previous blocks are getting disturbed, then the subsequent blocks will also get disturbed. So in this way, one cannot do any tampering of the blocks. Thereby, we can achieve the immutability or tamper-proof block creation. Next is transaction do not convey the identity and as they are represented using hashes. So complete anonymity is maintained in the block body. We have seen in the elliptic curve cryptography public keys generation. So in order to generate the address of a cryptocurrency, so first keys were generated. First, a private key is chosen with which a public key is created, and the public key is hashed so that whatever the hash value you got is the address of the account. So like that, this particular cryptographic hash function will help in generating the addresses, thereby anonymity can be maintained. Blockchain uses hash algorithms that produces 256 bit length hash value. So there exist some cryptographic hash functions. They, based upon the cryptographic hash function feature, the hash value length will depend. For example, if we are working with the 256 bit hash value, then the hash message register will be of size 256 bits. If you are using MD5, then it may be of 128 bit. Like that, depending upon the cryptographic hash function that you use, the hash value length will be decided. Another thing is, hash value is used to compare the data. That means whether the two data items are same or not. In order to check this also, hash values can be used. If both texts are same, then you will get the same hash value. Otherwise, you will get the different hash value if you run the hash functions on the data. So here are the list of hashing algorithms available, such as message register 2, which is a one-way hash function used in privacy enhanced mail along with MD5. Next one is message register 4. It is one-way hash function used for pretty good privacy. MD5, improved version of MD4, but it produces 128-bit digest. MD2, MD4 is not used today because those two are broken. Message register 6 is another thing, which is some advanced version of MD5. Havel, which is another hashing algorithm. Variable length one-way hash function and modification of the MD5 algorithm. RIPE MD, popular hash algorithm across Europe. In European applications are using this particular technique. Next one is simple hash algorithm, SHA0, which is the basic hash algorithm. Later, this algorithm is replaced with the SHA1 and SHA2. SHA1, this is a simple hash algorithm version 1. It has been compromised and replaced by SHA2. So the reason, don't use the previous thing. You may use MD5 algorithm, then you can directly come to the SHA2. So simple hash function algorithm 2, version 2, upgradation to SHA1 with various hash lengths. Here SHA2 has the various versions in this, which will produce 224 bit hash value or 256 bit hash value, 384, 512, like that, various hash lengths are there. But the cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin or many of the blockchains like Ethereum and many other things will use SHA 256 hash algorithm for generating the hash values. Now we'll see in how many ways hash data can be generated. First one is independent hashing. Independent hashing means you can generate the hash values of text individually, like hello. If this hello was placed on the hash function, then some messages you will get. Then world, this world is a word. If you place it on some hash function, some messages will come. Like that, independently you can do the hashes. Or you can combine both the text and can do the hashes. Or hierarchical hashing. Usually this hierarchical hashing is a type of Merkle tree way of doing. Hello, generate the hash value of this hello. World is a normal text. Generate the hash value of this normal text world, and whatever the hash values you get, those two hash values again combined it and run on the same hash function, and so that you will get new hash value, which is called a root hash value. So it looks like a binary tree, a root consisting of the left child and right child, and left child is attached with the original text, and right child is also attached with the original text. So whenever the root is known to you, even though you don't know the normal things or this intermediate nodes, but if you know the original data, then you can easily identify that whether is there any tampering occurred in the original text or not. Because if you do any small change, the subsequent subtrees related hash values will be changed. Thereby, the root hash value will also change. Thereby, entire hashing or integrity validation will be failed. Next one is repeated hashing. Hello world is a text. Then it is kept on the cryptographic hash function, so that you will get a hash value. Once it is placed on the cryptographic hash function, then we will get the hash value. Whatever the hash value you got, again you run on the same cryptographic hash function, so that you will get new hash value. So this is the repeated hashing technique. Bitcoin blockchain or Bitcoin cryptocurrency uses this repeated hashing. So Bitcoin blockchain use double SSA 256 hashing. That means whatever the transaction generated, that will be kept on SSA 256 hash function. Whatever the message register code it generates, that message register code will be placed again on the SSA 256, so that you will get the second hash function, hash value. So this is what is called repeated hashing. Sequential hashing means first hello is the word that will be sent on to the SSA 256 or hash function. You will get a message register. That message register is added with the second part of the text, that is world, then again hashed it, so that you will get a new message register. So this is what is called sequential hashing. So there are many ways. In these ways, the hashing can be performed in general. But in Bitcoin and cryptocurrency and other blockchain, majorly double hashing, or you can say repeated hashing, is popular. Further, it is very important to understand the properties of hash function. Let x be the input of any size. It may be a 1 bit, or it may be a 3 bits, or it may be 5 bits, it may be 1 GB, or it may be 1 terabyte, irrespective of the input size. Let x be the input of any size, but the hash function h of x will always produce fixed length message digest. Hashing should be deterministic and pseudo random. So for every input that is provided, we should get one message hash value in a deterministic manner. That means within a fixed number of steps. Hash value or hash should be collision free. That means for two different data items, they should not produce same hash value. Like for example, let x1 and x2 are two messages, and x1 is not equal to x2, then h of x1 is not equal to h of x2. That means if both the data items or data are not same, then they should not produce same hash value. So this is what being called the hashing should be collision free. To find collisions, try 2×n/2 randomly chosen inputs, where n is the length of the hash value, then there will be at least greater than 98% chances that two inputs will collide. So this is what the pigeonhole principle or Bartlett paradox. So the reason it is always recommended to choose a lengthy hash value generating algorithm like SHA 256. That is the reason MD5 is not popularly used, but SHA 256 is very famous. That too The Bitcoin cryptography algorithm, cryptocurrency, blockchain will make use of the repeated hashing so that first 256, even though if they guess it, then again 256 bit hash value generation. Identifying those things are in a random way, it is very, very difficult to. It is very, very difficult since they need to make several combinations or several permutations. Currently, that much computation power is not present in any computer. So it is the reason it is a very difficult task for anyone to break the particular code or to guess the code. Next one is this particular procedure of identifying will take too long time. So is there any fast method to find the collisions? So no hash function has proven so far collision free, but they tried very their level best for years together, but still they didn't, since they didn't find any collision. So the reason the people said that okay, this function so far, or this particular hash cryptographic hash function so far have not identified any collision. So the reason it is safe to use like that, but no hash function has been proven so far as a collision free. Other properties of hash functions are hash functions should process hiding. Like for example, given a digest of h of x, it is impossible to find x. That means whenever the cryptographic whenever the message digest or hash value is generated, with that hash value, getting the original text is highly impossible. That means it should be only one-wayness. Is the above statement is always true? Okay, it may fail in case a very small set of values of x. For example, if you are always giving the values like true or false, or head or tail, or zero or one. So if the input size is small, then it is very easy to guess whether based upon some trial and error method, if this continuous sequence of values are having the same message digest, then they may guess. But input size is sufficiently long, then it is very difficult for guessing. So hiding property states that if k is chosen from a very spread, that is from very spreaded out of probability distribution, no particular value is chosen with more than negligible probability or having high min entropy. So then given hash function, given h of k, given x, it is infeasible to find x. So this is what is called a cryptographic hash function, that is one-wayness property. And one more thing is hashing should be a puzzle friendly. Usually, in order to reach the consensus of a transaction among the peer nodes in the crypto, in the blockchain network or peer-to-peer network, they need to solve a hash puzzle. This hash puzzle, hashing should be puzzle friendly. That is, for every possible digest value, some digest value, if k is chosen from a distribution with a high min entropy, that means high min entropy means low probability of guessing, then it is feasible to find x given that h of k plus, that is addition, x is equal to dv. So that means it is very difficult to identify x even though you know the digest value. So this is a general puzzle friendly property will be followed in the cryptocurrency. So here are the various cryptographic algorithms. The comparison was given here. So in this comparison, how many iterations the hash functions will carry on, so that they will get the message hash value finally. So MD5 will go for 64 rounds of evaluation, in which they have used AND operations, XOR operations, modulo operations, etc. FSA 0 is of 80 rounds, FSA 1 is of 80 rounds, FSA 2 is of 64 rounds. So like that, there is a table. Okay. So majorly all these hash function algorithms or hashing algorithms will use AND operation, XOR operation, NOT operation or ROT operation, addition, modulo operations, OR operations, like that. These are the most commonly used logical operations in the hashing algorithms. So as part of our course, we no need to construct the SHA 256 from scratch, but no need to understand the in detail working procedure of the SHA 256. However, I have given the working diagram here. This was taken from Wikipedia, and initially there are some steps that need to be followed. First one is the padding. Second one is the block decomposition. That is, the entire block will be decomposed into 64 words of 32 bit each. And in the step 3, initialization of the hash values. These are the hash values, default hash values that was provided. Those hash values will be used. Next, in step 4, initialize array of a round constant. The round constants to be initialized. Then in step 5, initialize the working variables to current hash values. So then, what are the values you have created in terms of blocks that need to be operated with this SHA-2 family compression function? The blue components perform the following operations. So these are the blue components here. They will perform these operations. So these are in this, all these operations are logical operations only. Here exclusive OR operation, here right shift operation. So these are the various logical operations will be performed. Then finally, implement the compression function in the main loop for 64 rounds. We have seen previously that the SHA 256 uses 64 rounds like this. That means whatever the input you got here, that will be sent on this computation functions, and you will get the different set of blocks like this. Again, this output block will be given as input. Again, the same operation will perform. Like that, this operation will perform for 64 rounds. That means 64 times this operation will perform. So then whatever the output you get is the hash value of SHA-256. So this is the way you will compute the SHA-256. However, for our course, we don't need to go in details of this SHA-256. But whatever the programming language you choose, in all the programming languages, the cryptographic packages are available. One only thing is you need to know how to use the cryptographic packages, in which there exists cryptographic hash function, SHA-256 functions are available. And only thing is we need to use those SHA-256 functions and generate the hash value. Okay. So this is the message digest. Look at here, hash is there, no? This is the message digest. If you type hello, how are you? So this is the message digest will be generated, which is called SHA-256. For this, you will find some library functions also. You can straight away use those functions and can generate this hash code. This is a 256 bit hash data, or we can say message digest. So the specialty of this hash data is, if you make a small change also in the original data, this hash value will be changed. For example, here I have kept a full stop at the end of the statement. Now I am trying to remove this. Let we'll see whether there is a change in the hash function or not, hash value or not. So for easy recognition, we'll see here 9972 is the ending number. We'll see whether the same 9972 will be available once I remove the full stop. So here there is no 9972, but you got different hash. E888, you got it. That means even a small change in the original text, okay, will change the hash value. So thereby you can identify that whether the data has been tampered or not. Whether the data is tampered or not, easily you can recognize with the help of hash function. So this hash function will help you to maintain the integrity of the original data. This particular data's integrity can be maintained with the help of this hash function. Now, I hope by this time you come to know what is meant by hashing. It will take any length data. For example, I have taken this is a message. Copy it and just I'm pasting here. Any length message, but it will generate always a 256 bit length hash code, or which is called as message digest. So this is what the beauty of hash function. If you even though you change make any small change in even though it is a huge data, even though you make a small change, for example, I am removing the letter G. So here in this, I am removing this letter G, but you look at the hash value was changed. That means irrespective of the size of input, it always produces a 256 bit data message digest. So in this way, the cryptographic hash function SHA-256 take any length input data, but will always produce 256 bit hash value or digest. So this is very popular in the current Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies, as well as in the blockchain. So we'll see some more topics in the next.